Rice placed Norma Jean, Norma Jane placed it Rice goal from Norm Jack. He said he won. For those of you who don't know, my name is Mitch Thomas. I'm the music coordinator of early service here at the church. I've been at this church for about 31 years because of this woman. So my little presentation today is a survey of sorts. How many people can honestly say they are here today because of Norman Rice School dragging me here?
Oh, dragging me.
Well, today, but how did you get to this church? People who came to this church ever because of Norman. Who's with me? So I see about 35 names. This is Sandra. In the song that Carrie wrote the lyrics to today, she made a comment about Norma went places because someone asked her. Norma is the master or the mistress of asking people to do things and getting them to say yes. When I first came to Auburn, fresh out of college, I'd gotten a job here in Auburn, and I came to Auburn and, of course, gave her a call because I knew I could probably get a free meal out of getting together with her right away. I think she actually cooked that day. And when I first came here, I didn't have a place to stay or a place to live, and Norma and Michael took me in, literally, and I stayed with them. And then when they got tired of having me, they found someone else for me to stay with. She called Bob Watkins. She said, "Don't you have a room down there?" At least you figured I need a little privacy. You probably did too. You still can't believe right now. I think I'm just one person that represents many of you as far as normally getting involved. But I'm here today to talk about, like Pam, her outreach ministry beyond this church. We all know what she's done here. She came here with four small children in tow in 1964 and almost immediately was asked by this lady right here, Betty Dexter, to not ask, into playing for the children's choir in Sunday school. And Norma did. And she began to do that, and every Sunday with those four children in tow, managed to get there. And then continued to play, was here to make music for these over 50 years for this church. What you should know is prior to that, as a freshman in high school, Norma, who is from North Jay, which is where I'm from as well, so we grew up together. In the same little church in the village of North Jay. This, at one time, the smallest church in the conference area, and then this was the largest church in the old main conference. And when Norma was a freshman in high school, she became the organist at the Wilton United Methodist Church. 65 years ago, she became a church organist. I don't think you retire from something like that. You continue. You will always be. That is your type. That is what you are. Like Pope is the Pope for life. She's the organist. And we're so grateful for that. I do want you to know that some of the things that she did for Outreach Reach, and I can't even begin to name them all, besides being a pioneer with the bells, and William will talk more about that, but starting so many different outreach things here. But about 25 years ago, Joe Beardsley and I, at the time, were co-teaching the Music Theater Camp at Mechelana. And this kind of woman, I said, "Norma, would you want to come and play with us?" And so she came, and she was our accompanist at camp, and she did that for many, many years. And then she became the pro-dean with me for a while, which is a big responsibility also at camp. Empire Grove. About 6 weeks ago, the folks at Empire Grove gathered together in our little chapel up there, and we gave her a night to remember as well, with an honoring of her other church home. Can I see hands of the Empire Grove folks? I don't know if you're here. 15 of us here today. So, and remember, we're a summer place. So people, you know, there are people that wish they were in Florida right now. They're sitting in the congregation. That, and if you don't know what Empire Grove is, it's an old Methodist standing ground, just on the fringe of town, where Norma, for 40 years at least, has driven out there, or stayed out there, for many years, driven out there for every time there was a need for her to play. Not only during the camp meeting week, but also on Sunday evenings for the Vesper services. And this summer, she did as well. We gave her a party this summer, but told her that if she's not ready to retire, we don't expect that to happen. And I will go along with that. So Norma is community. There's no better word to describe her. Not only that she is part of every, a strong, important part of every community she's in, whether it's the music or the nurturing that she does, just being a mother, which I can say, with all due respect to my mom, Norma has been that to me. She does occasionally when we've been playing me as her fifth child. So, and I'm in between sometimes. And but she is community, and she is welcoming to community. And then the last story I want to tell before I introduce Norma's family is that Gladys tells the story better than I do. But when a day or two after I arrived, Norma started taking me around to places, and we would ride in the car. I would follow behind. And she and Mike and I would just go meeting people. She wanted me to meet everyone. So she brought me to this church. She brought me to, took me to a show at the theater, talked, told me I should audition for the theater, and that kind of got on. And then just all the kinds of stuff. But one of the things she did is that we, on a summer afternoon in 1984, we showed up with my brand new keyboard, not even out of the box yet. They just picked it up at the music store. At Gladys and Maynard's pool party at their home, and she's hauling in, they swung open the gate, this is Mitch, you all need to meet him, and he's got, and he brought his organ. And so there next to Gladys and Maynard's pool, I pull the organ out, and we had a singer. And that was Gladys' introduction to me, which is why she's coming to us. But that's Norma, introducing you to the community, being community. And we would be remiss today not to introduce her family who are here with us. First and foremost, her loving and devoted husband, these many, many, 35 years almost that they've been together, Mr. Michael Gould. Coincidentally, my choir director, everything in our jet, and was the person who let me sing in a choir as a soprano at the age of 8 years old. And then I moved sections. But that was normal. And then Norman and Burl would put me in their car when I was in middle school and high school at Russell and Norman's invitation and drive me down here at least one Sunday a year, usually in the summer, and let me sing in this church long before I ever was or imagined that I would become a part of the music ministry in this church. So I owe it not only to Norma and her father, but also to Norma for putting me where I am today. And again, I can say that because I think I represent many of you about where we sit, where what we do in music and in our ministry today has so much to do with this woman. So on behalf of all of us, your family and your community, Norma, we appreciate you so much. Thank you.